This lecture was recorded on February 15th, 1970, in the morning, and it was in Gorakhpur, UP, India. It was on the occasion of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati's appearance day. That day we fasted in the morning up until noontime. Then we offered a regular noon meal. And in the evening time, there was a feast of four preparations: puris, halva, vegetable, and chutney.
Great. Bhagavata. Not only his name, but also his activities and his qualities. These qualities, last time somebody was discussing with me, saguna and nirguna. Saguna means, according to their version, or a standard version, saguna means the material quality. They worship saguna roop. Saguna means forms of this material world. Sadhukhanam hitarthaya brahmana rupa kalpana. Kalpana. According to Mayavadi school, the absolute truth is impersonal. In the Bhagavad Gita, it is also said, Klesha adhikarasti sham adhikatarati sham abhaktya saptasita. Say for meditation. It is very difficult to meditate on impersonal features. Therefore the artificially things like that, I am the whole, I am moving the star, I am moving the moon, or some color display is taking place, artificially. This meditation is artificial. Therefore they do not get any result. Simply waste time and they remain the number one devotee as they are. So this kind of meditation, because they will not put any form, the Brahma is impersonal, so how they can think of any form? It is very difficult to adjust. Therefore, Bhagavad Gita says, Klesha adhikatarasti. They want to meditate upon impersonal Brahma, but it is very troublesome. Because Brahma is not impersonal, but force they want to make Brahma impersonal. So, in order to mitigate this troublesome position, some of their acharyas, Shankaracharya, has said that you imagine a form. There is no real form, but you imagine some form. And he has recommended five forms. The first form is Durga, Shakti. The second form is Surya, the sun, sun worshiper. And the third form is Ganesha. And the fourth form is Shiva. And the fifth form is Vishnu. Of course, these are the different stages of spiritual development. Durga means the material power, energy. So, when a person is in the lowest stage of material existence, he realizes some power. That's a fact. The scientists also, they realize some power, there is some power in the material world. They go on searching after, so what is the ultimate power, but they cannot find it out. That is not possible. But they accept that there is some power. Nature's power. That is the stage of Shakta stage, Durgavad. Then power, just like modern scientists, they also have gone to the power of the sun. That power is sun, and that is called Saura, worshipping the sun. Just like there is a Parsi community in India. Fire worship is recommended in the Vedas. So, that powerful sun god, they worship the sun. That is the stage of Saura stage. And then next is the power vox populi, the power of the vote. That is the stage of Ganapat. Gana means the number of people. That's like in nationalism, they are counting upon the power. In this way, they realize some sort of power. I mean, it's moving force of the soul. That is the stage of, they say, Sivoham, Aham Brahmasmi. That is the stage of Saiva. And when they expand that this power, this spiritual power, soul, is all over, all pervading, impersonal, Brahma. That is, they sometimes accept Vishnu. Vishnu means all pervading. But their realization of Vishnu is impersonal. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was discussing with Ramananda Raya, so what is the process of elevation, sadhana, that is the ultimate objective. So Ramananda Raya quoted a verse from the Vishnu Purana that the varnasrama charvata purushena parapuma Vishnu aradhate nanna tattosu karanam. The beginning of real human civilization is observance of the institute of four varnas and four ashrams. That is the beginning of civilized life. Otherwise, it is not civilized life. It is crude, uncivilized life, where there is no varnasrama, where there is no division of society according to work and quality. An ashrama, spiritual life division. So, Ramananda Raya recommended this verse. That this is the process to satisfy the Supreme Lord Vishnu. Where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that yo bhajyadika, this is external. If you know something more, better than this, he said. Why, he said? There is the person, Vishnu aradhate. Vishnu, does it mean that he is rejecting Vishnu worship? No. It's not rejected. Because generally, these impersonalists, Mayavadis, they also worship sometimes Vishnu, these five demigods and God. But their idea is the ultimately impersonal. The impersonal takes the form by the help of this material world, the form. Formation takes place simply in the material, that is their opinion. And therefore they say called Sagunupasana. Just try to understand this. Sagunupasana means when Brahma takes a form, he takes a form from this material help. Just like we take a form, we spiritual entity, we also take a form, transmigration of the soul according to karma. I create a certain type of mentality and that continues throughout my life, and at the time of death, because I have got a certain type of mentality, man mentality or God mentality or dog mentality or swine mentality and any kind of, there are so many. So I have to take a certain type of body. That body I have to test, not by my will, daivena, daivanetrena, by the decision of higher authorities. Daiva, generally it means the Supreme Personality of Godhead and His agents. He has got many, parasasakti vividhaivasriyate. So the material agent is Durga. So I create a mentality by my association with this material world. There are three kinds of qualities. Sattva-gun, rajagun, tamagun. So one of them are mixed, I will have to accept. Because I am associated. Just like, this is not difficult. If you associate with the hippies, you will become hippie. If you associate with the Vaishnav, you become Vaishnav. That is practical. So similarly, if you associate with tamagun, one of the features of tamagun is laziness and sleep. I am against so much sleeping because it is tamagun, it is a manifestation of tamagun. So this is the feature of tamagun. And the features of rajagun is very active, but for sense guide beings, just like ordinary persons, they are very active. They rise also early in the morning, they work very hard, but the whole plan is for sense guide beings. That's all. That is rajagun. And satagun means they are silent, they are sober, they know what is what, and they try for spiritual advancement. That is okay. So, you can understand whether a man is in satagun or a man is in rajagun or a man is in tamagun by the symptoms of his behavior. So, as we associate with different types of gunas, we develop a certain type of mentality that continues, and if it continues up to the point of death, then certainly we'll have to accept a body influenced by this guna. That's what Bhagavad Gita says. Prakite kriyamanani gunai karmani sarva. That's what this gunai. Prakite kriyamanani gunai. According to the association of guna or quality, prakriti gives you a certain type of body. The body is given by prakriti, by nature. Therefore, nature is called mother, Durga. Just like we develop this body, exactly from the mother's womb. The father gives the seed. But the bodily ingredients, that is, just like mother is developing her body, similarly she is developing the child's body also by eating, by the secretion, by development of the secretion. Here is solidifying the secretion. It is becoming gradually muscles, skin, bone, as it is becoming harder and harder. This is a very nice factory is going on. That is also by nature. And nature is working by the order of Krishna. That ultimate cause is Krishna. So, this bodily development given by the nature is also adduced to the body of Krishna. That is Mayavadi philosophy. Mayavadi philosophy means they accept Krishna as God, but he has assumed a body which is given by this material nature, as it is given to us. That is their point. They count Krishna, an ordinary man, on the same level. But that is not a fact. Therefore, Krishna condemns this philosophy. Avajananti manga mudha manusam tanumat. Because I appear as a human being, therefore these rascals consider that I am ordinary man. The rascals, mudha. Mudha means rascals, gadha, asses. Their designation is given by Krishna as asses, rascals. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu therefore says, Mayavadi bhaksa sunile hoy sadbana. Because these commentaries, comments by the Mahavadi school, is simply rascalism. And if one hears such commentary by the Mahavadis, the result will be, he will be doomed. Doomed means forever. For a very, very long time, he'll not be able to understand his relationship with Krishna. That way he's dumb. And because he is not able to understand his relationship with Krishna, he is called Rakhas, Aras, Asuri Bhavamas. That is also condemned by Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita. Namang Duskidana Murha Prabhadante Naradhama Maya Apuritagyana. You'll find amongst them very, very learned man, very, very good scholar. They can quote intelligent man because they are Mayavadi commentaries. They can utilize. And Krishna gives them intelligence also, that you misuse this verse in this way. Because you aren't. Tanahang Dishatat Kuran. Krishna is sitting within the heart of everyone. So Mayavadi philosopher wants to kill God or Krishna or Nidvishesa Sunnavadi. They want to make Krishna as zero or Krishna as nirakar. So Krishna also gives them intelligence. Yes. You just put forward this logic, that logic, that logic, and you prove. And that is also confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. Sarvasya chahang ridhisannivis. I am sitting in everyone's heart. Matta smitigyanam apuhan. Matta through me, from me, all remembrance or memorization takes place. So Mayavadi wants to prove that the ultimate truth is nirakar or impersonal. So Krishna gives him intelligence. Yes, he put this forward, this logic, this logic, that logic. Similarly, Krishna gives, there is a Bengali proverb that how God works, that one man, a householder is praying to God, my dear Lord, there may not be any theft case, burglary in my home this night. Please save me. Now one man is praying praying like that. Another man is praying the thief, my dear Lord, this night I shall commit burglary in that house. Please help me to get some. Now what is Krishna's position? Krishna is everyone's heart. So Krishna has to satisfy so many prayers. The burglar and the thief and the householder, so many prayers. So Krishna's adjustment, but he still, that is Krishna's intelligence. How he adjusts? He gives everyone freedom. And everyone is Krishna given him facilities, but still he is in bothers. Therefore, Krishna advises to his devotees that don't plan anything. You rascal, you nonsense, you don't give me trouble. Please surrender unto me. Just go under my plan, you'll be happy. You are making plan, you are unhappy, I am also unhappy. I was unhappy. So many plans are coming daily and I'll have to fulfill. He's merciful. So, accept the devotee of Krishna. Everyone is simply giving Krishna trouble. Therefore they are called duskritina. Duskritina, most miscreants. The miscreants. Don't make any plan. Accept Krishna's plan. That is simply giving trouble to Krishna. A devotee does not pray even for his maintenance. That is pure devotion. He doesn't give trouble to Krishna even for his bare maintenance. If he has no maintenance, he'll suffer fasting. Still, he'll not ask Krishna, "Krishna, I'm very hungry, give me some food." Of course, Krishna is alert for his devotees. But a devotee's principle is not to place any plan to Krishna. Let Krishna do. So simply we have to do according to the plan of Krishna. So what is our plan? Our plan is, Krishna says, sarva dhanman purittajya mamekam sarva. That's manvana bhavamad bhakti madhyay. So our plan is the same thing. We are simply canvassing for Krishna that you become Krishna conscious. We have to show our example how we are becoming Krishna conscious, how we are worshipping Krishna, how we are going on the street for vibrating Krishna's name, transcendental name. Now we are distributing Krishna's prasadam. As far as possible, our business is to induce persons how he becomes Krishna conscious. For that reason, you can make your plan. Because that is Krishna's plan. But that should also be sanctioned by Krishna. Don't make your own manufactured, concocted plan. Therefore, to guide you, a Krishna's representative request. That is spiritual master. So, there is a huge plan and huge scheme. Therefore, we have to follow the footsteps of the Mahajan. As it is stated here, then, dadasaite bijanima dharmana bhagavatam bhata. He says that we, the selected Mahajan representative of Krishna, we know what is Bhagavad Dharma, what is Krishna Dharma. Dadas means 12 names already mentioned. Sambhu, Narada, Sambhu, I have explained. So, Jamaraj says, only we, these 12 men, representative of Krishna, we know what is Bhagavad Dharma. Dadasaiti, Bijanima. Bijanima means we know. Dharmang, Bhagavatam Bhata, Dviyam, Visuddhang, Durbodham, Jangatyam, Mridamasnate. We know. Therefore, it is advice. Mahajana Jena Gata Sapanta. These Mahajans, as they have prescribed, that is the real way for understanding Krishna's spiritual salvation. So we are following the Brahma Sambhrada, the first Sam Brahma, Brahma, then Narada, from Narada Vyasadeva. In this way, Madhvacharya, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in this way. So today, because we are following the footsteps of Sri Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada, so this is today's his appearance. So we should honor this tithi very respectfully and prayer to a Prasiddhanta Saraswati Goswami that we are engaged in your service. So give us strength, give us intelligence. We are being guided by your servant. So in this way we have to pray. And I think in the evening we shall distribute prasad, not at noon. In the evening there will be so many audience come. So they can be distributed prasadam, and some of the members who can come from Bhatika, they can be also invited. So arrange for this. And at 12 o'clock we offer Pushpanjali. That Pushpanjali mantra, it should be beginning, it should begin from the beginning. You are singing Sivasa Bhanavi Devi. There are two other lines. Why do you forget that? No, before that there are two other lines. What is that? Why do you forget that? Yes. So you can chant this mantra and offer Pushpanjali flower. We shall together offer flowers. Actually, the worship is, that's my duty, but Sagosht, now I'll have to offer my respect with my spiritual family member. Sagosht, that is called Sagosht. Just like Vyasadeva says, Dhimai, he's offering prayer, Sagosht, with all his followers and disciples. That is the process. So this flower offering will be done at 12, and I think feasting will be in the evening. And after offering this Pushpanjali, we can take our usual food. But the feasting may be done in the evening. Make like that. Because some audience, some members, visitors come, they should be given. And you can ask that Maka. Maka, his name is Maka? Podhaji.
Bunker.
Yes, Radha Sama. And some other. And you can invite Dr. Ravisnath, his brother and his wife, and anyone who have made friends in the meantime, some of them.
Where
should we place
the picture?
On the altar?
Next to
you? Just where there is space.
Where shall we
stay
in the people?
Oh, there are so many places.
Not in
Israel. Huh? Not in Israel. Why
not
Israel? Yes. Yes.
And when shall it be served? After the Arati?
After the Arati, a little talk, that's all.
Then you say to And how many men will you say we should prepare there for? 100?
That you make arrangement. You know how many people are coming. Why are you asking me?
So,
ordinary prasad, noontime, and feasting prasad. Feasting means puri and halwa and a vegetable and a chutney. That's all. Four things. Make simple.
Do you want us to offer your Guru Maharaj at noontime, special place?
Not a special place. The process is that whatever you offer to the deity, that is offered to Guru. And Guru offers to his Guru. In this way goes to Krishna. We don't directly offer Radha Krishna. No, we have no right. neither he accepts in that way. The pictures of the acharyas, why they are actually, one has to offer the plate to his guru. And he'll offer his guru, he'll offer his guru, in this way it will go. That is the process. You cannot directly approach Krishna or other subordinates to Krishna. That is not possible. As we do, that is all right. The process is this, not you are you. That is the process. Then all right.